The Leon Gallery is mounting later this month the 2021 Asian Cultural Council auction, featuring a rich selection of artworks and furniture that underscore the influence of Chinese culture. To talk more about the upcoming auction is Lisa Nakpil, curator of Leon Gallery. She now joins us via Zoom. Thanks for joining us.
Yeah, good afternoon. Thank you for having me.
Ms. Lisa, I just wanted to ask, how has the pandemic, affected the growing art scene in Manila? Since, a couple of years back, it's been gaining traction. People have been attending galleries and art fairs. But now, with the pandemic, that put it to a full stop.
Not exactly, because Leon Gallery was fortunate to have invested maybe 2 or 3 years ago on an online infrastructure. So we had been able to tweak and improve and actually bring the auctions online very successfully, actually.
So would you say that because you were able to establish your presence online, the adjustment has been quite easy? And in fact, there has been more traffic in your site?
That is correct. And also because people are trapped at home and with nothing to do but to read and enjoy art.
So are you...
It's very soothing, art is very soothing in the time of this pandemic.
So are you seeing, more people falling in love with art compared to before because of the pandemic?
Yes, there's several new groups of collectors who are younger, also just as savvy, and they have different interests from the more, the more usual or well-known collectors that, you populate the art pages.
The art pieces and the furniture that you'll be auctioning, are these pieces that were made or painted by the painters or artists during the pandemic, or some of these old or antique?
No, the upcoming auction on February 27 is definitely the first major auction of the year. So it covers, there will be treasures from every century. So we're talking 1700s, 1800s, as well mid-century moderns. Of course, there will be a Juan Luna, and many of the well-known contemporary artists will be there, both young, not so established, young Turks, but also the more established, well-known names like Benkam.
And it's quite hard to curate, an auction with a mixture of old and new, but how are you able to put both generations, and both times together to make it quite an exhibit and an auction, in fact?
Well, the beauty of collecting is that you can live in any time frame that you wish. You can walk with Luna and Jose Rizal, like you have on the screen, that Sorprendidos, which was painted by Luna on his honeymoon in Venice. Or you can be mid-century modern, like the first, one of the foremost Filipina painters of the 1950s, which is Anita Magsaysayho. Or you can go brash and exciting and abstract, like there's Anita Magsaysayho. She was the first winner of the AAP most prestigious contest in the 1950s. But there was, you will also have HR, her contemporaries, Cesar Legazpi, Nena Sagil will also be there from the collection of F. Shonil Jose, who is a national artist, and he also had his very own iconic Solidaridad galleries. In fact, what's making it wonderful about this auction is that many of the pieces have been curated ahead by great collectors from Shonil Jose, Beniting Legarda, Carlos P. Romulo, and of course the collector that started it all, Don Alfonso Ongpin, whose father stands guard over Binondo at the entrance of Ongpin Street.
Funny that you mentioned that.
That's him over there.
But how can you say, after mentioning all of these well-known figures, what's the influence of Chinese culture in the Philippine arts, and how has it meshed so well that we've fully embraced it?
Well, the Chinese is a 10,000-year-old culture, and because of Confucianism, they value many values that I think resonate, or maybe like with Jose Rizal, resonated with Jose Rizal because he himself, his grandmother was from Fujian province, mm-hmm. was a Chinese mestiza. So Confucianism puts a very high value on hard work, discipline, and moral values, which is something that resonates with Filipinos. So it was the days you have Confucius himself. So with the artists, the first thing that you would see is that there are many Chinese collectors like Don Alfonso Ongpin. And to this day, many families with Chinese ancestry and heritage who carry on this tradition. Now, the Chinese Filipino collectors are characterized not only by their great wealth, but also their desire to conserve, preserve, research, and take care of these many wonderful Filipino paintings. As for the Chinese artists, we have, of course, Anita Magsaysayho, mm-hmm. who technically married into being a Filipino Chinese. There's Ang Kyu Kok, and of course, Lau Lian Ben.
Masisa, is there a piece that you're expecting to get the highest bid on?
You know, the people are speculating whether it will be Anita Magsaysayho's mm-hmm. Tinapa Vendors, which she herself, that's Ang Kyu Kok, she herself said was one of her favorite market scene. That's the one. It's a Tinapa Vendors, 1955. She was already causing a sensation as the top Filipina artist in the Philippines. Or would it be Sorprendidos, which would be Juan Luna's intensely personal painting of his honeymoon mm-hmm. In Venice? You know, that building still exists. Yeah. You can actually check in at that hotel.
And you know, before, as we wrap up, when will the auction be held and how can people, I guess, sign in or register?
Okay. My favorite part, you can now go to leon-gallery.com and send an email to info@leon-gallery.com or, I can't remember the numbers now, but the auction will be, and that's burned into my memory, Saturday, Feb 27, beginning at 2 p.m. You can bid online, by telephone, by email, or if you can make appointments, and there are select slots for people, if you reserve ahead of time, to go and actually be on the floor while the bidding happens. It's going to be live. Okay. But also streamed on Facebook and Instagram and our website.
Okay, thank you for that, Miss Lisa Nakpil, curator of Leon Gallery. Thank you so much for joining us.